What is up, you guys? This is Mini Superheroes Today.
This is pretty dang cool. These are all four of the LEGO Marvel Eternals sets that LEGO sent me early to review. Now, I'm actually not allowed to open them or review them for a little bit yet, but I'll explain everything here in the video. There are four Eternals sets. We have the Eternals Aerial Assault being the smallest set, the Deviant Ambush being kind of, you know, that $25, $30 set kind of deal. Then we have the In Arishem's Shadow and the Rise of Domo, which is the biggest set and probably the one I'm most excited about, but they all look really cool and I'm excited to build all of them. So let me explain what's going on here. So LEGO sends out sets early to review and whatnot, and we're allowed to actually talk about the boxes and the box art, but I can't physically open anything and show you anything inside until September 14th, 2021. So that's still a little ways out as of this video, but I can at least talk about the boxes and kind of show you that stuff. So if you haven't already, be sure to hit like and subscribe down below. That way you can stay on board and check out these reviews once they hit my channel. But yeah, let's actually start talking about the boxes now. So let's start off with our smallest set, the Eternals Aerial Assault. This comes with Sprite and Ikaris. Now, a couple of things to note is when LAN sends these sets out early, you get this cool not for sale sticker on the bottom. So nobody even asked me if these are for sale because they're not for sale. Anyways, the other thing is they're almost always the European boxes, and the European boxes don't tell you how many pieces come in the set. So that's pretty interesting. But we've got our characters on the side here. Of course, as always, we've got our one-to-one scale figure on the top, and then when we flip it around the back, we can see one of the Deviants there with Sprite and Ikaris. So there's not too much to this set, actually, for us to be surprised by, because it's just a small little build, but I'm actually excited to build this one. Should be really cool. Up next is the Deviant Ambush. Something I love about this is that there's an exclamation in the title. Deviant Ambush! Anyways, it's a giant Deviant this time compared to the smaller one in the set we were just looking at. But it comes with Fina, Makari, and Gilgamesh. Really, really cool. And check out these new, like, flame fists for Gilgamesh. That's a new piece. All the figures do look really cool, like the new head for Gilgamesh. This is a reused head, and I'm pretty sure that's MJ's head from Spider-Man, but a new hairpiece, so that's cool. Of course, we've got our characters on the side, as is tradition for this wave. And yeah, it's really cool. I don't really know if there's any, like, secrets hidden in the back. I really like the artwork and all that there. That looks pretty cool. But, yeah, not too much to say here because, again, it's just kind of another Deviant build. Here we have In Arishem's Shadow, and a lot of people are excited about this because, of course, it's a giant celestial build. I like that it's kind of built like a mech, so if you're like a mech customizer, you can definitely have a field day with a set like this, but it comes with a little Deviant and several characters this time around. Check them out. We have Ajak, who's exclusive to this set, Kingo, who's exclusive to this set, Ikaris, who does come in some other sets, and then, of course, Cersei, which is really, really cool. So it's nice to get basically three exclusive minifigures, and the box art for this one is just beautiful. The box art for this one is absolutely beautiful. There's a little light brick that goes in the center here, so even that's a cool, unique thing. Here we've got a one-to-one character. Of course, all four characters on the side, just like our other boxes. And yeah, it's really amazing. Look how awesome the Celestial looks. He's massive. And then, of course, we can see all of our Eternals characters using their powers to fight off this Deviant. So really cool. There she is standing in his hand. And look at this. It is 11 inches tall. Check that out in the box. 11 inches tall. Absolutely incredible. I'm so excited to get that one built up. Here we have the Rise of Domo, which is probably the set a lot of us are most excited about just because of the size. I'm in absolute awe at the size of this unit, to quote the meme, but anyways, it's really, really incredible. We do get a giant Deviant here that's actually pretty similar to the one in this set. I'd be interested to see size-wise, you know, how close they are. They look really, really similar. Anyways, it comes with Crow, who's kind of our, like, big bad villain, I guess, of the film. At least that's how the trailer made it look. And we do have several minifigures here. I guess that this is kind of like the Eternal Starship that they like fly around in. So that's pretty cool. But let's look at our minifigures. We do have some repeats with Makari, Cersei, Fina, and Ikaris, which is kind of annoying to, you know, have four characters that are repeats from other sets. And it's crazy too that I'm not 100% sure this does look like a reused head from MJ, but If that's true, then everybody but Fastos has reused heads in this set, which would definitely be a bummer, but I guess I have to open it up and see for sure. But, of course, on the side of the box, we do have all that artwork, just like the other sets. Then when we flip it around, it's honestly pretty incredible to see all the detail that is packed into here. So I'm looking at this for the first time, honestly, guys, so I'll just kind of unpack things as I see it. Looks like over here there's like a video game controller and a mine detector hanging on the wall. That's kind of interesting. Over here, look at that. It looks like the Celestial that we saw in the other set. It's like a hologram or maybe a statue of that. That's pretty interesting. Over here, I really don't know what's going on there, but it doesn't hurt to show it off on the box. And then looking inside the ship, looks like there's like a little scepter hanging on the wall there. Looks like there's a bedroom back here. I just really like that this set looks lived in, you know? There's a place for a pilot up front. Just looks really cool and looks a lot like Jack Kirby kind of art and all that great stuff. So really, really cool. And I really am excited to get this one all built up. So yeah, let's zoom out and I'll give you my final thoughts on all of these new Eternal sets. Well, at least the boxes, since that's all I can talk about right now. Well, guys, let me know which of these sets you're most excited to see me review and which ones you're most excited to add to your collection. That'll help me decide what order to upload the reviews in once I'm allowed to. And yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. So thank you guys for your support. Thank you for being a part of my community that allows things like this to happen. And yeah, I'll catch you guys on the next video. Well, you've made it to the end of the video. You should hit like and subscribe down below for more LEGO content from me, because I post just about every single day. You'll be up to date on all the latest in LEGO, so why not join my community and hit subscribe now.